Hi, Phil Thomas Katt here, and welcome my friends to the Uncharted Zone, the Mullet Toss Show. I'm here with the craziest guys at the Bama, Rusty McHugh, Mike Fincher. How you guys doing?
Just fine. Good to be out here with the old zone. How you doing today, Michelle? Behind the camera, by the way. Good to see y'all.
How about you, Mike?
Oh, just doing fine. Feeling like frog hair, you know.
Well, tell me this. Are you able to toss a mullet? What's your distance record?
Mine's about 3 foot behind me. They always slip out of my hand.
How about you, Rusty? Any better?
And we don't have a chance to throw it. You know, we're usually down there. Either they make us announce it or pick up fish or put them back in the bucket or something. We're usually down there in some professional capacity, if you understand what I'm talking about, you know.
No, but we catch them.
Oh, y'all catch the mullet.
That's in the zone.
Well, I've often wondered, what do they do with these mullet? Because I think you could have one heck of a fish fry afterwards, huh?
They're kind of squished. Sandy and...
Well, you know, you can hose them off.
You don't know where they've been, though.
The people or the fish, man?
Probably both.
Well, you know, I don't know, man. You know, that'd be a good question. We need to ask somebody about that. What they do with all the mullet? They probably just die and go on to mullet heaven with the rest of them up there, I guess. I'm not sure.
Bless their hearts.
About that. You know, be a good deal, though. Refried mullet for a big festival. They got the big, you know.
Mullet pudding.
Finger pudding.
Well, listen, I understand you've written a song just for the mullet toss.
Well, I got one here. Let's see if we can get through it. I'll try it for you. Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, while you might get lucky, you can throw it with the mullet queen. Or you can get... Ah, shit, we got to do it again. Can you cut that out of there somewhere?
Yeah.
All right. Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, you might get lucky, you can chunk it with the mullet queen. Or you can lay in the sand listening to band. You can get drunk with me. Damn it, I can't do it. I gotta do it again.
What's he meditating over here?
That's where he writes songs.
Is that right? Well, we're watching a historic moment here.
Could be. May not be.
I can't remember this verse. I think it's
yeah. Just sing one verse.
One.
Okay.
Well, Phil, how you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Okay, here we go. Well, you grab your mullet by the tail or the gullet, and you give that bang a fling. If you get lucky, God dang it. Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, while you might get lucky, you can chunk it with the mullet queen. Or you can go swimming or hit on the women, got everything you need. Or you can lay in the sand, listen to the band, or you can get drunk with me. 'Cause we drink all day and party all night, and on Sunday we praise the Lord. We make a party out of throwing dead fish now, brother, tell me we ain't bored. Now, if you want to get you an important job, brother, we know we'll let you. I'm fucking this thing all up. I hate it because I can't remember the damn word. You want to try it again?
Yeah.
Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. If you hang tough, while you might get lucky, you can chunk it with the mullet queen. Or you can hit on the women, or you can go swimming, and got everything you need. Lay in the sand, or listen to the band, or you can get drunk with me. 'Cause we drink all day and party all night, and on Sunday we praise the Lord. We make a party out of throwing dead fish now, brother. Tell me, we ain't bored. Yes, sir. Now, if you want to get you an important job, brother, you know we'll let you. It looks like to me you could be the official mullet catcher. While you run through the sand waving your hands, imagine how funny you'll look. Pretty neat trick, catch a mess of fish, never even have to wet a hook. Hey, we drink all day and party all night, and on Sunday we praise the Lord. We make a party out of throwing dead fish now, brother, tell me we ain't bored. We make a party out of throwing dead fish now, brother, tell me we ain't bored. Been a while since I've done that, so excuse me on that one. Thank you.
It's like Christmas songs. It only comes once a year, huh?
That's right. A lot of other things, too, I'll tell you. We're getting an audience over here. There's some young mullet tossers coming up over here. There you go. Does your fist fit a fish?
I feel Thomas Katt back with Rusty McHugh and Mike Fincher. And you guys have a brand new album coming out. Can you tell me anything about it?
It's plastic and it's round and it's got songs on it.
Okay.
Yeah, what we do is we'll just write them, you know, and then we play them in here, and then after a while there'll be certain ones that pop up that they like more than others, and we decide to put those on tape. And we got a CD coming out, you know, it's got that Louisiana lip lock on it, along with that My Truck, and also our famous Walmart song for all of you that wanted that one. It's coming out on this next one here too, and we're gonna try to make this thing. We're going to try to release it at Mullet Toss. So come on out here. We're going to have a booth right around the corner here, I think. And Jimmy Lewis is going to be involved with us. And it's going to be a big deal this year. I'm telling you, we got people coming from all over. Lots of good entertainment. And I tell you what, we're looking forward to a bunch. I'm telling you. And what other time would be better to release an album when 40 or 50,000 people are coming down here to eat fish and throw fish and have a big time at the Flora-Bama? You know, I'll tell you. Looking forward to it ourselves. Hey. Why don't you come on out here?
I will. I'll be here. I'm always here.
Bring her with you too, okay? Good deal. That's right.
Now, how long have you guys been working on this particular CD?
About 3 days, I think.
Is that right?
No, it's been a while. We've been working real hard, and we're kind of proud of this one.
Party boys get a drummer this time. I think we're going to name this one the Panhandle Poon Daddies, but it's not official yet. You know,
okay.
So we're trying to figure out what a poon daddy is before we go and name the band.
We'll know tomorrow, which is Mullet Toss Day, right?
That's right. That's right. Oh, yeah, that's right. Coming out tomorrow. All right, slipped up on us.
The print shops will be working overnight to get this thing ready.
Right. Get it zipped back in here. And all the, you know what all the mullet in the area look like, don't you?
Like a turkey on Thanksgiving.
Oh no, that's right. They're gonna get tossed out here tomorrow. That's right. I'm not sure of which celebrities we got coming out, but you know, there's usually a whole host of people that are to come out for this thing that in all capacities, you know. I was going to say something about Kenny Stabler in the past, but I'm not sure if Kenny's going to be involved in it this year. Maybe I shouldn't say anything at all about that. But anyway, okay.
And I wanted to ask you a little bit. I'm getting a lot of talk on the street about folks that really, well, they really like this this video that you did recently over at the Perdido Cove restaurant. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Oh, yeah. That was actually the song about the bitch that ate too much. It's kind of gotten to be an anthem. We got this thing down in Panama City. We invited a gal out to eat with us one time. Like I said, she wasn't a real big gal, but she just had a big appetite. And when we walked out of there, I just had never seen anybody devour so much food in such a short period of time, and I turned around to my friend Ray Tweed and Michael here, and I said, "Boy, I have never seen a bitch eat that much in my life." And so that afternoon, it became a song, and so we went over there to recreate the atmosphere of the original recording as good as we could. Went to Perdido Cove. One of our favorite restaurants over here.
And one of our sponsors.
That's right. They're right. They sponsor UZ. And they're some of our favorite people over there, too. And with Michelle's help and the Uncharted Zone, we made a hilarious video. And I just like to invite everybody to check that thing out. It's kind of a pictorial review of that lovely afternoon down there in Panama City. So do check that out. I never met a bitch that could eat this much to this day.
Now, which album is that song on?
It's on Mike and Rusty... Friends album.
Friends, oh, okay, the first.
But I'd also like to plug Phil and Michelle here. They're doing a heck of a job on these videos, and any musicians, I get it out in a minute, any musicians that like to have one done, they've got a program set up now that really can help you. So they're the geniuses behind this. So y'all check them out and give them a call. They'll give you a good rate.
We appreciate that, and we'll flat sure do it.
A flat rate.
We got anything else you want to say before we go out there and toss some mullets?
Well, shoot, no. I'm just ready to fire it up and go on out there. Y'all come on out and check this thing out. You'll enjoy it. And don't forget, pick up one of these next CDs. You'll be glad you did. They got them down here at the old Flora-Bama gift shop, you know. They got a Coca-Cola sign and a concrete floor, and they can throw a party now, that's for sure. People lined up out the front door to get in the Flora-Bama. To get in the Flora-Bama. To get in the Flora-Bama.
Well, you know I'm making it when I'm singing with superstars.
That's right.
Thank you.
Keep in touch, my friends.